The Cyens Weekly, an industry pundit podcast about the tech and innovation of the 21st century. An open discussion between industry experts to uncover how emerging technologies can help solve current societal issues.
I'm here with Kleanthis Neokleous, who is the ITICA Research Group Leader of Cyens. First of all, thank you very much for being here with us. So the ITICA Group focuses on bringing together elements from fine arts with computational technology and emerging technologies such as virtual reality, augmented reality. Please tell us a bit more about yourself and your work at Cyens.
First of all, thank you, Maria, for inviting me. This is a very good initiative, and I hope that it goes well and you continue doing that. Okay, as for me, in my background is I come from engineering background and then to computer science, and many years I have been working with VR, AR technologies. So it's like I'm not so much related with arts, other than that I like observing and watching nice artworks. But what I saw and realized, and that started a few years ago when the CEO of Ars Electronica visited Cyprus on that event, and I had the opportunity to have a discussion with him, I realized the opportunities and how can, when you blend these disciplines together, how can you have creativity, which means innovation. And this is exactly what we need. So I thought that that was a gap that we needed to fill here in Cyens, and I thought, let's give it a try. As I mentioned, I'm not from that world, but I could see it as a more abstract level, and I could realize how things could be done, and trying to bring a solid and a good team together, that helps a lot.
Trust me, all of your projects, every time I will come across one of your projects, I'm just taken aback from the variety and the way that you guys manage to combine research, technology and arts in a way that it's more about having innovative ideas, as you said, and not just the pursuit of style, let's say. As part of your work at Cyens, which would you say was one of your favorite projects to work on?
Ah, okay. Actually, we want to have a little bit of style as well, so...
Well, you're not in pursuit of it. You managed to have it originally.
So, yeah, I mean, thank you for this comment. I think the bottom line here is that we enjoy what we did, and that, as I mentioned before, it all ends up at the team and how capable these people are that we managed to join together and bring together. Now, I don't have any particular favorite of the projects, but now that we are here and I'm next to the Leader Palace Hotel, I think that that might have triggered a little bit, and kind of I enjoyed it perhaps a little bit more than other projects. And it's, you know, at the end of the day, you see what the outcome is and the response from the people looking at, and I think that's when we got the biggest response from.
Exactly. Do you want to tell us a bit more about the work that your group did in collaboration with Museum Lab for the Leader Palace exhibition?
Yes, all of the work was done with respect to the research and the reasoning, and all started from Theopistis' idea, and that was a vision and an idea she had a long time ago. And we started it with Buffer Fringe, and then we said, okay, let's try and continue that work. Our group was mostly responsible for the technologies used in the museum. However, we were part of the creative team as well, let's say, and we participated in several decision-making meetings. But the curation and the reasoning and the idea and the concept was all came out from, and the research and all that work came out of from the museum lab.
Okay. Well, you mentioned before that you yourself, you don't have a very art-related background. How would you say, in simpler words, how can we connect art with technology and research? And is that combination in any way harmful to either art or culture? How do you balance it?
Okay, so, well, as a new person coming into that world, and you know, always at the beginning you're so excited and you see the opportunities. I realize also a little bit of the challenges that we find here, and the challenges are that we're talking about two different worlds, and the way coming from the engineering and the computer science background, we are a little bit more squared in the thinking and in the logic of how we approach things, while the creative sector tackles these issues a little bit differently. And that was a challenge on how we managed to communicate between us. Now, if this is harmful, I will totally disagree. I will say that I mentioned that earlier, is that this multidisciplinarity and this mixture of engineers, scientists, and artists together elevates the element of creativity. It's not 1 + 1 = 2, it's 1 + 1 = 3 and 4. It's exponential, the benefits that you get out of it. And by having creativity in a center that invests in state-of-the-art research and technology, that's the best recipe, in my opinion, for innovation. And that's what we need to boost up the ecosystem of the city and the country and the region in extent.
Exactly. How open would you say was the local audience to this combination? Or how aware we are, let's say. Because, well, if this is something new, bringing two seemingly completely different worlds together, with all of the work that you have already done here and with the exhibition and other projects that you worked on, what was the reaction that you got from the public? Within this industry?
Well, okay, still we are at the infancy of our efforts. And first of all, this is not a new concept. It's been going on in Europe. I mean, Ars Electronica exists since 1979. So definitely it's not something new. Perhaps is new in Cyprus, while I'm just understanding and realizing that it's even in Cyprus is not new. There are many organizations and many actions, perhaps at the more individual level, that have been working in this area quite some time ago. That's good, because we have a good indication that this is a successful recipe, but also we have a solid background that we can build on top of and bring these people together here in Cyprus. Now, the reaction, okay, I mean, still we are at the first steps. These are the first efforts we are doing and presenting our projects towards the society. So, I mean, the feedback we get is always positive. There are some comments or some suggestions, some feedback that we are always considering, but still, we are at the very first stages. And I think that's how we should approach, small step at a time until we manage to make something a little bit bigger and create an image and a name of ourselves and establish ourselves here in the country as a group or a center focusing in arts and technology.
Okay. What would you like to see in the future? If you could have, if you have an idea, how would you enhance this concept? First of all, in Cyprus, what is something that you would like to see in the near future, maybe even 5 years from now?
Well, definitely, I want to see this being a success, because we know from examples in Europe that it's been going on and it's very interesting and it's being supported, and it also helps to the sustainability of the organizations that follow that concept. However, I mean, we need to understand also the position that we have and see the challenges of a small country. On the other hand, we have also some very good opportunities that we can take into advantage. As a small country, it means that we are very flexible and capable in pilot testing and experimentation in new things. We are also, we have this situation that is unique. We are the only divided country capital in the world, so we can use this let's say, momentum and this energy that can come out of this multidisciplinarity to contribute towards that direction and help our island become a better place to live. So definitely I would like to see this effort being a success and evolve and becoming bigger and having a good impact back to the society.
Okay, so since the public gave us positive feedback, and this is something that people are already aware of, did you make any moves towards enhancing this concept? Is there a strategy in place already?
Well, yes. The strategy is to make small steps at a time, and this is what we're trying to do. We managed through our network and through collaborations to enter into this STARTS initiative, which is an initiative by EU facilitating the concept of arts and technology. And we were lucky enough to be part of a consortium at the project that we participate with, very highly prestigious and well-established centers in Europe regarding arts and technology. That gives us a lot of, helps us gain a lot of experience through our involvement to this project. So the idea is to get this experience, get these opportunities that come in our way and use them to go one step further. So the STARTS project is about hosting a residency that we have the open call at the moment, and we expect to get some very interesting applications in collaboration with PwC. And it's about, we are looking for ideas about how we can think of sustainable tourism. And the idea behind the reason behind this title of our residency is that we are a small island and that we are hosting about 3.5 or 4 million tourists each year, and we are only 800,000 living in the country. So we have a huge impact into our environment, into our lives, into our society, and we want to challenge and seek for interesting art projects combined with technology through this residency. Now, as I said, this is one step. Then another step is we want to make small events that will help us embrace and bring closer to our effort and to our vision the local community. And like, for example, this event that we're having next week on the 1st, 2nd and 3rd of November, the Work in Progress event, which we will be hosting projects from students from the from the Lund's Arts University and also local universities. And the goal will be eventually to have like a big festival in the city regarding arts and technology that will help us establish our position in the region as an arts and technology hub. So yeah, I mean, the answer to that is small steps at a time and bringing the local community to help us move forward with collaborations and with networking.
All of this sounds very, very interesting, and we look really forward to seeing that. So you mentioned that you would want to eventually create this festival. Will you say that this is probably one of, let's say, your ideas for how you would want to see the future being shaped around this concept?
Well, not exactly. I mean, that's a central element of the vision, definitely, because is the way that we can elevate this concept and then get all the other benefits that come along with it and help us have greater impact back to the society. And that is very much connected, as we mentioned before, with the innovation, meaning for the sustainability of the center, but also to help the city, the country, and the region. And we are a very small country that has a lot of challenges, but also a lot of opportunities. And this is something that could definitely have impact back to the society. And this is how we think and we envision our efforts to evolve over the next few years, with one of the central pieces being the festival.
That is excellent, and best of luck on any new project that you will take on. We would be very excited to see everything, you know, taking shape and form. So thank you very much, Kleanthis, for being with us today. It was lovely having you, and thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for inviting me.
This podcast is brought to you by Cyens, former RISE, the Research Center of Excellence in Cyprus, focusing on interactive media, smart systems, and emerging technologies. For more information, please check our website on cyens.org.cy.